Good evening to you all, and wonderful to have you here. As the theme, I would first start talking about the New Age careers and then how at School of Liberal Studies the pedagogical advantages one can have. So we started our journey at Pandit Dindayal Petroleum University. As you can see, I show you the brief snapshot of what our campus is. It's a 100-acre lush green campus on the knowledge corridor situated in Gandhinagar. And at PDPU, we house three faculty of management, faculty of technology, and faculty of liberal studies. We started our journey in School of Liberal Studies in 2009. And we are on our way to induct the 12th batch this year. While we, any counseling that I give to parents and students, their end purpose is to get a good career. Now, while the end goal is the same for all, to get a good career, the definition of good career varies from people to people. Because I always say amusingly that English dictionary have two separate words on two separate pages, success and happiness. So we are always on the lookout for something that gives us success and something that gives us significance. So I say that human life is comprised between B and D, that is birth and death. But between B and D, we have C, a choice. So when it is talking about our future career, we always have a lot of questions, and parents and students ask me, where do you see my son or daughter? I smile and say, I prefer not to, because times are changing very, very fast. And as we all know, we are ushering into the fourth revolution. In fact, we are already in the fourth revolution. And this fourth revolution is called Industry 4.0, wherein the world is mostly governed by IoT, augmented reality, Internet of Things. And right now, I mean, in the case of pandemic, we are proven right, because we are meeting virtually through the interface of cyber technology. So human beings fear that in the world of Industry 4.0, most of the manual as well as the human jobs, even the creative jobs, would be taken away by machines. And we always find the caution given to us on the side glass of our car, where it is written that the objects in the side mirror are closer than they appear. Likewise, this disruption that we are going to anticipate in the world of Industry 4.0 is much, much nearer than we can anticipate right now. And therefore, with the demanding times, we require demanding skills. So I say this is not the time of leapfrogging, wherein we have time to modify our career interest and our skills. These are the times of pole vaulting. And how do we pole vault? What are the new age careers that we see? As you can see on your screen, some of the interesting careers that are emerging in front of us. Right now, some of these careers might look ridiculous and far too advanced, but I'm very sure that in the days to come, with human interface, most of these careers would be very, very relevant. Careers like the digital rehab coach, or the career where the person would work as senior citizen companion or senior citizen caretaker. The alternate health therapy would come in a big manner, because we have created a lot of issues through our recklessness and carelessness, and COVID-19 is one such example. So people would be trying to find out alternate health therapies also. The digital musical expert is something we find a lot of film songs are being transferred, and they have the new even right now endeavor and my friend moderator who was helping me. Actually, we are meeting through the human machine interface, and this human machine interface is something that people would be looking for. So I'll talk about some of these careers very briefly, and then talk about some of the skills that would be required. So what are the skills that people would find out? We are passing through a very critical phase of COVID-19, and hopefully we will overcome this very soon. When we overcome this, we need to understand whether it is the millennials or the boomers or generation X, Y, or Z, whatever it is, people are going to grow old. And the type of lifestyle and the smaller family size that we have, there would be huge demand of people who would have an understanding of the human behavior, the psychological understanding of senior citizens, empathy, and a lot of other things. So the youth who can handle not just the travel, being the travel companion for the senior citizen, but also helping senior citizens to various surveys would be in a lot of demand. Another that I see in demand is, right now it is okay because we are passing through the lockdown phase and we are using a lot of data. But world over, parents and the guardians are very much worried about the use of the data that people are spending every day. And more people are complaining of frustration and anxiety that comes through the extended, prolonged contact with social media. So every family would be requiring the services of the digital detox coach. These coaches would prepare the tailor-made schedule for family and individual of how much time they should be spending on social media and what social media they should be spending time on, and how much time should people actually spend outside so that they stay healthy in body also. Another career that I see that would be coming up in a big manner is that of being organizational disruptor. Because I was just teaching Brave New World to some of my students of English literature, and in Brave New World, there is a catch slogan that mending is better than ending, but it no longer stands true because all organizations are passing through a lot of changes, whether these changes are forced, whether these changes, same style of working is not going to work. So with the organizational disruption around, people would be hiring the experts who would understand the organizational behavior, the working of transnational companies, human psychology, and the aspects of marketing and business. So the organizational disruptors who would change the entire working system of an organization would be in huge demand. Also, it's not just the product brand that we are talking. And a lot of big people, they require a personal brand manager. These personal brand managers maintain close attention on hashtag trends going around, the newsmakers, what are the news happening all around the world, and what should be a proper way of communicating. So an excellent interpersonal communication ability and street smartness can help one to become the personal brand manager. And we are already seeing how different cricketers and film stars and the politicians are using the help of personal brand managers. Okay. Another thing that I see in a big way coming up is agriculture. And you may wonder that I'm here to talk about liberal studies and why am I talking about agriculture and floriculture. So the purpose of talking about liberal studies is it gives you the pedestal of transdisciplinary understanding, and then you capitalize it or to go on for a special business. So an understanding of food geography, culture, and various aspects of agriculture like hydroponics and organic food would be in a lot of demand. Also, as we are passing through critical time and a lot of people are talking about talking about anxiety syndrome, frustration, depression, and you might be surprised to know that one of the most successful courses at Harvard University is a course on happiness. So in the days to come, the society would require the help of a memory surgeon. This memory surgeon with the understanding of the human psychology, culture, the political scenario, the economic position, economic possible economic meltdown and all, would try to erase the trauma and negative memories from people's mind and would try to bring back happiness. At School of Liberal Studies at PDPU, we teach international relations as in political science. But I see in next 10-15 years, we would be in lot of demand for the political experts of the outer space. As you see, our scientists in ISRO are making huge leapfrogging and pole vaulting towards advancement in science. And those days are not very far where the mega powers would not be competing for the natural resources on the planet Earth, but would also be competing for the natural resources on the outer space. So the understanding of the politics of outer space would be the new age career that we see. Also, I was talking initially about human machine team manager. And as you see on the screen, the maximum command that Alexa is getting in India is to play Hanuman Chalisa. So the cyber human interface is something that is connected with the culture, deeply rooted culture. So the understanding of the human machine team manager would help the programming officers and the people who work on algorithms to work with machines that help human beings in a wonderful manner and shoot not only just the local requirements or the national requirements, but the international requirements as well. Okay, so having talked about this, some of these careers that might be coming, you might be wondering then which discipline to go for or which area should I go for? I say that the selection of a major and minor is relevant, but that's not as relevant as an understanding of the skills that might be required. If I give you the metaphor that I would like to throw to you is that of a container and the content. The container may change, but the content is crucial. So the gold per se as a metal is more important than the forms of whatever gold ornaments that people wear. So what would be the skills that would be in perennial demand, irrespective of whether we are talking about current phase or whether we are talking about 20 years down the line? What would be the skills that people would require? Skill number one is excellent interpersonal communication ability and ability to connect to people, to understand what people require. Second would be multilingual ability. When I say multilingual ability, I'm not counting English as a foreign language at all, because English is almost an Indian language now. So what are the, where is the development coming from? Or where are the problems coming from? The understanding of languages like Japanese or Mandarin or French or Spanish would be very much critical, because we are not just competing. I tell my students, we are situated on Bajipura Road, and I tell my students that we are not competing with Bajipura boys and girls, we are competing with the global task force. And as such, multilingual ability is something that everybody needs to have. The problem solving ability of working in a heterogeneous transdisciplinary group, where you are not just working with people of your area or your discipline, but with many other people. Spatial intelligence. By spatial intelligence, I say the ability to join the jigsaw puzzle. I'll just give one example. If one is aspiring to become a good manager, manager at the end of the day would be working with human beings. So the understanding of human psychology is important. The understanding of the economic policies of the country is important. The understanding of the diplomatic relation one's country has with neighboring countries is important. The understanding of culture is important. So everything down the line is connected. So no working in silos, that is my recommendation. Transdisciplinary approach to all challenges, industry exposure, because theory must be complemented with real-time challenges or how people are solving these challenges in industry. The research exposure for the undergraduate students is something that is very, very essential. Your CV should have some paper presentations, dissertations, and the inclination to research advanced digital literacy is something that people would require. And one thing that I take as a compliment is street smartness, because you might be a scholar, but if you are not street smart, then you might not be able to sell your own personal brand. So these are the things that would be required. Now, talking about very briefly about what the School of Liberal Studies at Pandit Dindayal Petroleum University offers in terms of courses, we have intake of 460 students, out of which 280 seats are reserved for BA, BBA, commerce, BA, BBA students, 120 seats are reserved for BCom students, and 60 seats are reserved for BSc students. Now, let me tell you how this functions and why we call it liberal studies. We call it liberal studies because, unlike traditional courses where you need to decide even before you make a start of what your specialization would be, and sometimes that can be suicidal. So, for example, in 1988, when I went to St. Xavier's College and I just blindly said that I would take up English as my major, I did not know whether I would be successful in English or not, or whether English would have a career or not. And I also did not know what was my core competence. So here at School of Liberal Studies, in liberal studies pedagogy, we allow students to enter undeclared. So they enter without declaring their specialization. First 2 years, they are exposed to 45 courses, out of which they have to take up 30 courses. Some are core courses, some are electives, which expose them to the wide gamut of courses to provide them a fair understanding of what they are good at. So basically, it gives you time to understand what you are good at, to be patient with yourself, and to find out where your career inclination lies. And when you come in your fifth semester, that is the beginning of a third year, that would be the time where you would be deciding your major. Major is specialization and minor is subspecialization. So on your screen, you see you have the choices of economics, English literature, governance and public administration, international relations, mass communication, and psychology as BA major minors. And in BBA honors, we have finance, marketing, and HR. Now, let me tell you how this crisscrossing happens. I can pick up finance major. My career path would be BBA finance, but I can also take up English literature or corporate communication as my minor from the BA basket. And likewise, I can pick up international relation major and can combine it with the BBA minor. So this way, students have a lot of flexibility even when they go for their major minor selection. To talk about BCom honors program, the BCom honors majors are specialization clusters are accountancy and finance, marketing and management, banking and insurance, and international business and entrepreneurship. While these majors are restricted for the BCom students, the BCom students again can opt for minors from BA. So the BCom student can pick up one major from this, the cluster that you see on your screen in BCom table, and then can also pick up from BA honors minor. That's not mandatory for them, but that's a choice that we are giving to them. And for BSc, there are three disciplines that we offer: physics, chemistry, and maths. And BSc students opt for their pathway from the second year. We also have postgraduate programs in economics, English, public administration, political science, international relations, mass communication, and psychology. And I would stop my presentation with the pedagogical advantage that I would want to talk about. When I say pedagogical advantage, how liberal studies is different. So the factor number one is liberal studies has to be non-judgmental. A person might not be very good in all disciplines, but person can be excellent in some area. So the inherent philosophy of liberal studies is not to find out faults, but to find out the core competence and strength of the student and to guide the student towards that. So we expose students to a lot of internships. At the end of first semester, in December, the students embark for 1 month residential rural internship, which they initially don't enjoy. But then the purpose is, if you want to lead India, you need to understand India first, and we want to take campus to the community and labs to lands. So the students stay with an NGO for 1 month, and they solve some of the real-time issues, grassroots issues of the rural community. During summer, we encourage and facilitate corporate internship for students so that they gain some experience of working with the industry. Also, for every undergraduate student, irrespective of their degree pathway, writing dissertation is mandatory. So that exposes them to research experience. At PDPU, we have a specialized Office of International Relations. We call it OIR. And one of the things that we do is we don't offer scholarship on past or class base, but we sponsor every student whose paper is accepted for presentation in a country abroad. So we tell students that you show your merit, you submit your papers, and go and make paper presentation. And the idea is to make every student having some double exposure. We also conduct audit activities during Saturday and Sunday. These are skill enhancement activities which students enjoy, like martial art, tie and dye, bandhni making, Japanese kite making, fire safety drill, and a lot of other activities that the students have choices on. We send our students in summer for international exposure in campus abroad for 1 month, which is partly subsidized by the university. We also sponsor four students for semester abroad in Minnesota University in US and Oklahoma University in US. The neutral third party scholarship of US consulate, which is known as U-grade scholarship, is acquired by students. So last 5 years back to back, students of School of Liberal Studies have got that fellowship and scholarship. We also send our students for a lot of field trips in SAARC countries and a lot of extracurricular activities. I hate this term, extracurricular and co-curricular, because nothing is extra, nothing is co. In fact, extracurricular and co-curricular are also curricular. They are, because they are mainstream, they are associated with academics. We have an excellent studio, audio-visual studio, media studio. The student in real experience of being in a television studio and can record, shoot, what we have been doing. I would be personally interested in solving some of the questions that you may have.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, can you see and hear me? Okay. Am I audible, Dr. Dave? Yeah. Am I audible now, Dr. Dave?
You are audible.
Okay. So thank you so much for that lovely session. We do have a couple of questions that have already reached me. So let me start with the first one. It says difference between BBA Liberal Studies and BA Liberal Studies. What's that?
In fact, the philosophy of liberal studies stops me in answering this question, because no discipline is higher, no discipline is lower. Every discipline has its own merits. So the difference between BA and BBA, as the name entails itself, when you select finance, marketing, or HR as your major. When we say major, major is depth. So you are studying number of hours in a managerial area, in management area. But along with that, why I'm slightly not in favor of calling one higher or another lower is, even a BBA student can pick up BA minor. Right. So the main problem with our contemporary society is because we have only seen the watertight compartments like BAs, BA and BAs, BBA. Whereas at School of Liberal Studies or in any good liberal studies organization, what you would see is you are a BBA student, no doubt. But you are also studying theater in the first semester. You are also being exposed to fine arts or world civilization, the areas of international relation, and you also have the liberty to pick up BA minor. The only difference that I would say is there are basically two types of people. It would be slightly improper to classify people in category, but for the understanding of people out there, let me say there are two types of people. People who are very creative, who are people-oriented, who are people's person. For them, BA honors is very good. Whereas there are people whose mathematical understanding is slightly better, who would want to go and expand their business and want to start their own business activities. For them, BBA honors is better.
Okay.
I hope I have answered the question. If you still have question, I'll be very happy to answer.
Sure. I'll be taking up more questions. So one student is asking, can I do minors in music while doing BBA from PDPU?
Sorry, I'm not...
He's saying, can I do minors in music while doing BBA from PDPU?
Unfortunately, right now, no. We have electives in music and we are thinking of starting music major from 2022. So okay. Right now, music is not one of the options for major minor. Having said that, we have an excellent performing arts room with all musical amenities. In fact, I myself... been the director of a keyboard. So I'm also personally interested in music, but right now that option is not available.
Great. There's one question which says, how much time throughout the 4 years will I find for pursuing my hobbies and interests?
I'll be very happy to answer that. In fact, the new education policy recommendations are already on the internet. So anybody can search and find out about the new national education policy that experts are recommending. World over, any honors program is always comprised in a four-year program. Point one, it helps people seamlessly integrating their further studies in countries abroad.
Right.
And we have partly understood this in India because our engineering programs are 4 years. But all these years, we have been slightly... we have been neglecting BA, BBA, BCom and traditional programs, saying that these courses are not professional courses. I hate this term because even a musician can be a professional, even a cricketer can be professional. So the four-year structure is ideally structured around providing equal balance to people in breadth as well as in depth. Otherwise, you end up in a position where people would start taunting you that you are jack of all but master of none. Whereas I say very proudly that my students are jack of all and master of at least one.
Right. Okay, I'll take one more question. Will the exams be conducted on the same dates that were announced earlier, or does this situation bring along any change in that?
I would be fearing this question. I knew that this question would come. So right now, the global situation is very volatile. Although we have an entrance examination and the forms are already out and a lot of people have already applied, we have been closely keeping in touch with and we have also put a instruction for all the possible applicants also that we are monitoring the situation very closely. As on date, it doesn't look too promising to conduct the entrance examination as we have been doing. But let me tell you, the alternate solution that we are thinking for entrance examination is we would be asking students to submit SOP, statement of purpose, letters of recommendation. We will be conducting their video interviews. And then as and when the 12th result is declared, that would be factoring in the admission. But the previously announced admission process, test of 50 marks, creative essay for 25 marks, and personal interview for 25 marks. And we have our test centers all across India. But right now it looks too bleak to me. I hope that I would be proven wrong.
Right. And can you just touch upon the dates related to the forms and the exam once again, and for the students who have joined us?
Sorry, can you repeat that again?
If you have any important dates that you want to share for the forms or for the exams?
The dates, current announced dates are there already there on the website. We were proposing to conduct the entrance examination in the end of May, but that looks improbable right now. So I will be very honest, we are not very sure of the exact timeline, but we'll be updating everyone. Through our website, through our social media, as well as those who have already applied. We're keeping our fingers crossed globally.